Well, let's remember the American Rescue Act is bringing $1.1 billion to Connecticut schools in part to fight COVID. So that'll certainly help. But there's no question school districts across the state are trying to balance reopening for in-person learning with a loosening of COVID restrictions.
The CDC is considering revising social distancing guidance for schools from 6 feet to 3 feet.
With regard to the 6 foot social distance guidance, that is impossible, quite frankly, to be able to maintain.
Here in Wethersfield, 85% of kids pre-K through grade six are fully in person. That means more bodies and less space between desks, but a renewed focus on other mitigation measures.
They include good hand hygiene, so frequent hand washing, ventilation systems that have dampers that are open to outside air, so we have a good airflow. And certainly the most important factor that we have seen thus far is consistent mask compliance.
But there are some fringe groups seeking to eliminate the school mask mandate. Governor Lamont says masks reduce infection.
I think the mask is one of the reasons.
Here's a visualization of COVID in Connecticut schools trending lower with 493 student cases and 156 staff cases for the most recent week of reported data. We're told space has also been a challenge in the school cafeterias.
We ended up purchasing convertible bench tables so that we could position them where all students were sitting in the same direction. So we do not have students eating lunch where they're facing each other.
And it's not just within the school walls. Reopening means more crowded buses. Wethersfield still committed to keeping a seat empty between riders.
Maintaining assigned seats for students as well. And then working with our bus contractors to ensure that buses are cleaned and sanitized on a regular basis.
The science behind 6 versus 3 feet is still out, although a study of Massachusetts schools with different physical distancing requirements did not show any significant difference in the COVID rate.
I would say I would not be comfortable with 3 feet if people were unmasked. But with a mask on at 3 feet, it's probably fine. Now, in the community setting, that makes me a little more anxious because when you're in the supermarket or people don't always wear their masks right.
The supermarket is where we found Lisa Butler. With a daughter in the school system, how does she feel?
I think that as long as the CDC says that this is recommended and safe for kids to be at a 3 feet apart distance, I feel it's okay. But also, I think there has to be some consideration given to the teachers that are in the classroom and how they feel about, you know, that requirement.
And keep in mind that most teachers are now vaccinated, giving them a little more confidence. Wethersfield told me their main problem with COVID hasn't necessarily come from the classroom, but rather the athletic fields. All grades here in town will be allowed to return fully to in-person learning by the end of the month. Reporting in Wethersfield, Matt Caron, Fox 61 News.